Good afternoon, this is Jill Dresser. I was going through our family archives and I found something crazy. It is actually a 400-year-old interview with a Puritan that is absolutely unbelievable. Watch this.
Good afternoon. So my name is Mary Dresser. I'm married to John Dresser. You may have heard of John Dresser, the shoemaker. Well, we came over from Yorkshire, England, a little town called Rowley. We were part of a congregation with Reverend Ezekiel Rogers. Ezekiel Rogers is a well-known, well-respected reverend in England. He would give monthly lectures and travel around the countryside telling people how to worship the Lord, how to be a good Puritan. King Charles I took over and he started passing all those nasty Catholic laws. Well, Ezekiel Rogers, the reverend, he wasn't going to stand for that. And we support him. So they told him that at his congregation, he would need to tell all the people. He would have to read to them the Book of Sports. The Book of Sports. You know what the Book of Sports is.
Nope.
Well, you don't know what the Book of Sports is. The Book of Sports is terrible. What it tells is it tells people that they can play sports on Sundays. So, of course, the reverend, the good reverend, he said, I'm not going to read that. And he stepped down and he stopped preaching. Well, he stopped preaching and we said, what are we going to do? We can't stay here. The plan was for us to all get on a boat and go across the ocean over to this new England because we've just heard about it. In fact, it had just started 8 years prior to this. So when we finally got word that we were going to be leaving, we got the ship and we all went down and we all crammed in there. Of course, Ezekiel Rogers was there. We had the first printing press with us, the first printing press. We brought that. Yes, we did. We do love our reading. We landed in Salem, Massachusetts, I believe the place was called. And it was so cold. Oh, we barely survived that winter. But we survived. We work hard. We're Puritans. We're industrious. We believe in working hard. That's what's going to get us to heaven is working hard. So we work hard. We survived. And then, Ezekiel Rogers, he was very smart. He managed to find some land that was right along the waterways. And of course, you want to be near water. We need some running water and some drinking water. And he paid £800 for a nice chunk of land right over in Ipswich in Essex County. So we call this land Rowley. We named it after our own town, Rowley in England, of course. And we set up there. Now we have a nice little lot of land. We each got an acre and a half, which was very generous. We have many, many children. Of course, my son, John Jr. is a lieutenant. I am very proud to say he is a lieutenant. He's a representative in the government. So he does work for the government a bit. And I don't want to say this too loud because I am a woman and I shouldn't really be talking at all. But
what do you mean?
They're going to call me a scold for talking too much. You know, that's what they call us. And if they call me a scold, women that are called scolds, they got to wear the bridle. I don't want to wear that. They'd have me standing in the middle of town with a bridle on my face telling me to stop gossiping and stop talking. But I do want to tell you this little piece of information. My son, John Jr., he's a little bit of a stubborn man. Unfortunately, a few years ago, the governor, Governor Andros, he landed in Massachusetts and he docked ship. He put his anchor down and then he came to town, the nerve of him. He had 40 redcoats with him and he came to town and he started trying to take taxes from us. Can you imagine?
Not today.
But we didn't agree to these taxes. We've got an assembly. You can't just tell us what to do.
That's right.
The governor was appointed by the Massachusetts Bay Company and the king. So he thought he had all the authority, but we said, no. So my son, being the hard head that he is, just like his father, he protested and he said he was not going to pay it. He didn't vote on it and he ain't going to pay it. Well, he spent some time down in jail and it was a few weeks he was in the prison there. And we do have some crazy laws. Mind you, all the laws keep the children behaved. And the laws certainly make me not gossip. I don't know if that's true. But some of the laws, you know, the fashion is a little bit extreme, how they want us to dress. It's a little bit awkward, I've got to be honest with you. Yeah.